can talk about how much now, when we think about art and the way in which we understand it, is really in some cases thinking about what empathy is and how it is transforming. Mm-hmm. What is the role, right, of empathy in art?
Or human.
In contemporary culture.
Well, I would even say human. And how do we as human beings interact with each other, and how do we negotiate intimacy, being open, having openness in a sphere when stuff is closing down.
I think of Simon when he was, my younger son, when he was about 5, sitting in the Rothko room in Houston and saying, "It's autumn inside." And then saying,
"Autumn inside."
He said, "It's autumn inside." And he said, "I feel, so sad. And nothing was telling him to feel that way except those paintings.
Right.
If you listen to a 5-year-old, they'll tell you how they feel around some art. If we learn how to be with art, like, that's what you feel. So many aspects of our amazing humanity."
When I first saw Julie's work, recognizing how many layers of other complexity can be embedded in a work of art that you sometimes don't need the art to tell you. You have to really engage and look deeper into the art to recognize so many other connections.
Would you say that, for the most part, your work is anchored in social justice?
I don't think about the work that I do in terms of questions of social justice, but I think about it in terms of my own subjectivity. So, the things that I'm interested in, the things that I have been curious about, the things that I have wondered about are important. It's not like hubris or overconfidence to think that, but it's like my subjectivity is important. Because everyone's subjectivity is important. And if that is social justice, like that basic thing that every person's kind of sense of themselves and their ideas and their curiosity is important.
I make abstract things. Those are all about experiences. They're not paintings.
Right?
They are about the individual experience you have with the painting and image in this moment, and what that image can be, and what it can invent and offer. So for me, I know that what I'm interested in most is that experience and what can happen in that moment. And I feel like there's value in that.
Mm-hmm. I always like to say that it doesn't have to look political to be political, mm-hmm. but all art is political.
Mm-hmm.
And that we do incredible civic work as artists, but up until recently, we haven't claimed our responsibility, our role as storytellers. Mm-hmm. The stories we tell are the stories that future generations will learn about our society from.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm really hoping, as scary as it is, to just kind of ask hard questions of ourselves and one another and implore the rest of our society to do those same things.
What does it mean to create actually the world that we would like to live in? What does it mean to remake the world, right? We do this with nuance, we do this with subtlety, but it's the artist that we look to, you know, it's James Baldwin knowing this, it's Howard Zinn knowing this and writing about this, it's all the ways that look to the artist to say what the politician can't.
Mm-hmm.